Welcome to Pinnacle Bank Arena. It's graduation day at Nebraska. Please be seated. Good afternoon, and welcome graduates, families, and friends, the university community, and distinguished guests. I am Ronnie Green, and I have the privilege and honor of serving as the 20th Chancellor for the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, our state's flagship land-grant Carnegie One Research University. Thank you for joining us here today at Pinnacle Bank Arena for Graduate Commencement Day at Nebraska. We are streaming live around the world for this incredible moment in the lives of our graduates and in the life of our university. Commencement is truly a special time. I am overjoyed that we are once again able to conduct in-person ceremonies and continue our time-honored tradition of presenting your actual diploma here on stage. Our university community is made up of students, faculty, staff, alumni, and friends who know what it means to be determined and resilient in the face of obstacles. We strive toward our goals by adapting and innovating. That is certainly true in what we might call a normal year. It has never been truer than over the past 18 months. I'm immensely proud of all of our students for what they have accomplished during this unprecedented time of COVID-19. Today, we celebrate the graduating class of 2021, and we are also so pleased to welcome back to campus members of the class of 2020 who now have the opportunity to claim this special moment in their lives of crossing the stage and being recognized for their academic achievement by the university community and their families and friends. Your perseverance through the greatest global health crisis in 100 years is why we are here today. Your resilience, your determination, and your grit are certainly a part of what we celebrate in this academic milestone in your lives. Today, we present graduate degrees to this accomplished group of scholars who will now share in an impressive heritage of this university. At ceremonies this weekend, we will confer 697 degrees, bringing our total to 305,667 degrees conferred since our charter date of February 15, 1869. We are proud of your accomplishments and thankful for your contributions. You have raised our level of critical thinking and creative activity as a world-leading institution of higher learning, adding to the legacy of people who have earned their advanced degrees here at Nebraska. Today's ceremony continues our time-honored tradition of presenting our graduates their actual diploma on stage. It's a very special Nebraska tradition that we are proud of, an endeavor that very few Big Ten universities are committed to doing. For those 2020 graduates who received their diplomas last year, you will receive a congratulatory certificate designed just for your class as you cross the stage today. This requires hours of behind-the-scenes work and careful preparation to ensure that you all receive your diplomas and certificates in person today. And so, I would like to start our ceremony today by asking you to join us in applauding all the staff, especially the staff in our Office of the University Registrar, who have worked hard to make this event possible. Please join me in thanking these individuals. Each of you represents a story of achievement. You may be the first person in your family to receive a college degree, as I was in my family in 1983. And like so many of our faculty, you may be a veteran who has returned from active duty to pursue your degree. You may be a Nebraskan from one of the 93 counties of this great state, or from one of the other 44 states, or 56 countries around the world represented in this graduating class. Today, you all have one thing in common. You are a graduate of one of the greatest universities in the world, the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. You have worked hard, applied grit, shared your talent, and earned a University of Nebraska degree. So celebrate this day. Celebrate your achievements, but even more importantly, join us in celebrating the possibilities that you are about to unleash on the world as you move forward in your careers. I officially declare the August University of Nebraska-Lincoln graduate commencement now convened. Now please rise, if you are able, as Trey Meyer, a Doctor of Musical Arts candidate in the Glencorf School of Music, leads us in the national anthem. Please direct your attention to the flag. Pursuant to an act of Congress, those who have served in the military may salute even though not in uniform. Gentlemen, please remove your hats.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you very much, Trey. Maybe he's going to give Garth Brooks a run for his money tomorrow night. To open today's ceremony, please direct your attention to the Husker Vision screen for greetings from Steve Colby, President of the UNL Faculty Senate, followed by Batul Ibrahim, President of the Association of Students of the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and UNL Student Regent, and Eric Rodine, President of the Graduate Student Assembly.
Graduates, I bring you heartfelt congratulations from your University of Nebraska faculty. From the extension educators who inspired you and the mentors who encouraged you, to the professors who guided you along your educational paths, we all wish you a lifetime of continued learning, happiness, and success. Your grit and determination has brought each of you to this moment. Savor it and celebrate. Go forth, do great things, and be amazing.
On behalf of those who are graduating today, this is a proud moment for us all. I would like to thank our university administrators, faculty, and staff for their dedication to the students. And to our newest graduates, we gather to celebrate the culmination of your Nebraska experience. I'm confident that each of you will leave the university prepared for satisfying careers and service to your communities.
My sincere congratulations to all of you today. A graduate degree represents the culmination of years of perseverance, hard work, and dedication. The academic foundation our university has provided will serve you well as you take the next step. Best wishes and good luck as you pursue your future careers.
I will now introduce members of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents and the University of Nebraska System who are joining us here today. Please stand as you are introduced. Regent Paul Kenney, current chair of the Board of Regents from Kearney. Regent Tim Clare from here in Lincoln. The University of Nebraska System Executive Vice President and Provost and Chancellor of the University of Nebraska Medical Center, Jeff Gold. Please join me in welcoming our university officials. Now please direct your attention again to the Husker Vision screen for a congratulatory message from Regent Paul Kenney, who you just saw, Chair of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents.
Thank you on behalf of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents. I'd like to say job well done. You've experienced your degree at a time when the University of Nebraska has experienced a year of great challenges, but you persevered, and today we are celebrating your accomplishments. I'm confident you will leave here prepared for whatever challenges await you. In the words of Warren Buffett, you have invested in yourself. The opportunities before you are limitless. Congratulations, class of 2021. I wish nothing but the best for you and your future endeavors. Thank you.
Also joining me on stage and on the arena floor are members of the senior administration of our university. Each member is listed in your program. They provide leaderships in all facets of university operations, and even though it may be invisible to you, each of us today has been affected by the hard work and the dedication of these outstanding public servants. I ask the entire senior administration to please stand so that they can be recognized as a group and receive our appreciation. The university faculty and staff form the heart of this great university, and we're deeply grateful to each of them for their time and efforts in helping our students reach their educational goals. Throughout the arena, you will see university marshals dressed in red robes assisting with the ceremony today. They are faculty and staff volunteers led by our head marshal, Dr. Robert Gorman, Associate Professor of Classics and Religious Studies in our College of Arts and Sciences. We're also grateful to members of the faculty who are attending commencement today. Will all members of the faculty and staff throughout the arena and on stage please stand? Please join me in recognizing the marshals and the faculty for their work. Seldom does a person accomplish something as important and as challenging as earning an academic degree without the support of a community of people. Family, friends, and mentors have been crucial to our students' success in reaching this milestone today. Through this pandemic, you have met the challenges of encouraging and supporting our students to reach for this academic goal and to accomplish it. Those of you who have provided this unwavering support share in the limelight of this occasion, especially this year, so that the graduates and those of us associated with the university can offer our thanks. Would all the relatives and friends of the graduates please stand? At graduate commencement, it has become our tradition to hear from one of our esteemed members of the university community to deliver the commencement address. Dr. Dan Linzell is the Associate Dean for Graduate and International Programs and the Leslie D. Martin Professor of Civil and Environmental Engineering here at the University of Nebraska. Dr. Linzell has previously served as the Volte Keegan Professor and chair of UNL's Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. He was an assistant associate and the inaugural John A. and Harriet K. Shaw Professor of Civil Engineering at Pennsylvania State University from 1999 through 2013. The emphasis of Dr. Linzell's research is structural engineering, with specific foci including response of building and bridge systems to extreme loads, specifically blast and impact, structural health monitoring, steel structures, the design and behavior of bridges during construction and under service loads, and advanced structural analysis. His research group has published over 100 peer-reviewed archival journal articles and refereed conference papers and abstracts. He teaches courses in bridge engineering, steel design, structural analysis, infrastructure resiliency, and structural health monitoring. Dan is chair of the Structural Stability Research Council, co-chair of the American Society of Civil Engineers Innovation Contest, a member of the Transportation Research Board's Steel Bridge Committee, and American Society of Civil Engineers Committee on Student Conferences and Competitions, and sits on the Board of Directors and Steering Committee for the Engineering Change Lab, USA. He is a fellow of his scientific society, a fellow of ASCE's Structural Engineering Institute, and a licensed professional engineer in Georgia, Nebraska, and Pennsylvania. He earned his PhD and MS degrees in civil engineering from Georgia Tech, and his Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering from, I have to call it, Ohio State University. I'll leave off that V. Dr. Linzell's remarks today are titled, Angling for a Better Future, Your Degree, How It Changes You, How You Change the World. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Dan Linzell.
Thank you, Chancellor Green, for the introduction. Members of the Board of Regents and NU system, vice chancellors, deans, family, friends, and most importantly, our graduates, it's my honor to speak to you on this monumental day, which just happens to be
Friday the 13th.
So, you spend all day trying to avoid all of the bad luck that could happen, right? So you didn't step on any cracks, mom's back's fine, didn't walk under any ladders, didn't see a black cat anywhere, and then Chancellor Green tells you, or you read in the program, that an engineering faculty member is going to give the commencement speech, and that the title has angle in it. And I assume you were thinking, all of that work that I did just went down the tubes, right? Bad luck is coming. That's not the angling that I'm referring to. It's what's shown in the photo that was up a little while ago, and that what you can see it up there now. Hopefully, don't injure yourselves, anybody. Maybe it's behind me, I don't know. And that's the angling I'm talking about. And I assume now you're also wondering, like, did I wake up at 3 a.m. on a Sunday morning, and am I tuned to ESPN2, right, when all the fishing shows are on? No. So here's the deal. It's me in the picture. Assume you figured that out. And I like to fish. I like to fish for as long as I can remember. I don't fish for food. I release 99% of the fish I catch. I fish because I like to. I have so much fishing stuff in our house that really we could hold, the Linzell family could hold an all-weekend garage sale, fishing-focused. That's how much I have. And I'm even a Pisces. My brilliant and amazingly tolerant wife, Cindy, who is in the audience today celebrating a good friend of hers' receipt of her doctorate, has grown to accept this one little bitty fault that I have, just one. So, but maybe the speech is a last-ditch attempt by me to convince her that fishing is a noble pursuit. I don't know. So anyways, why in the world am I telling you that I like to fish and force you to look at the Dan the Dork photo that was just up there a little bit ago, rather than, you know, the mugshot kind of thing with my clip-on tie and my lapel pin and all that good stuff? It's because I feel there's a lot of commonalities between the pursuit of fishing or angling, and the pursuit of an advanced degree, and how your future pursuits will and really must impact the world. So let's talk about what happens when you go fishing. So grab your stuff, you head to water, you tie something on some line, and you throw it in and you wait, right? I think there's more to it than that. You're trying to achieve a goal, catch one fish, without really knowing how you're going to achieve that goal, when it will happen, right? Really, not necessarily even how. If you achieve your goal, do you quit? Probably not. You set another more aggressive goal. So let's figure out, what's the next goal? Two fish, right? And you start all over again. You keep angling for a better outcome. You keep angling for a better future. You keep casting your line in the water. What has always intrigued me about fishing is, irrespective of all that stuff, of what companies are trying to sell you, that basically they're saying, you buy this and the fish will just come right to you. You really don't know what's going on in the water. You have no idea. You really do not know what is happening down there, and you especially don't know what's going on in the brains of these fish that you're trying to catch, which, by the way, are about that big, right? And that could be a whole other discussion about why our brains are trying to catch those brains, but I won't get into that. So you ask yourself all these questions while you're trying to catch the fish. Are they hungry? What are they eating? Where and why? Right? Can I convince a fish that isn't hungry to eat? You ask your questions of yourselves, you change your approach and you continue to challenge yourself to achieve your goal. You may not see the outcomes of these decisions immediately or even in the near future, but you keep casting your line in the water. Isn't that really what you've been doing while you've been pursuing your advanced degree here? In your classes, with your research, your performances, your clinicals, and moot court? Really, everything associated with your academic pursuit over the last 1 to some number greater than 1 years of your and your friends and family's lives, you've been casting your line into the water, really not knowing what will happen. What keeps you going? It's your drive to catch that fish, achieve your goals. Irrespective of whether you're successful today or not, do you catch a fish? You learn, adjust, and try again the next day. And just like fishing, the more you adjust, the more you cast, the higher the likelihood of success, and the closer you get to achieving your goal. Your time here at UNL, gaining the knowledge and skills you need to become a better performer, scientist, sociologist, psychologist, educator, medical professional, and I'm going to say engineer, by learning from and working with the amazing faculty who are here, and also your amazing peers, improves your angling skills. You get closer to catching that fish, be it creating an iconic piece of art, figuring out how to improve food production, successfully arguing your case in front of mentors and peers, learning how to better educate English language learners, whatever. And when you catch that fish, maybe you try to catch another one, a bigger one, eliminate world hunger, poverty, pollution, illiteracy. You cast your line into the water yet again. So here we are. You've landed enough fish to receive your graduate degree from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. You should be commended for continuing to cast, not giving up when the concept was hard to grasp, aria hard to sing, experiment hard to complete, data hard to get. When a pandemic hit, you didn't stop casting. You did it. Don't stop casting. The world is an interesting place right now. I assume we all can agree that that is the case. You are the ones who identify opportunities to address the problems that exist and move civilization forward. What you learn as you angled for your degree at UNL better prepares you to cast your line into the water as you try to catch a better way of treating illnesses, catch a legal decision that benefits a vulnerable group, catch a dance performance that inspires, catch a poem that challenges. You may not catch a fish right away, but keep casting your line into the water. You will soon catch them, and you will make the world a better place. And so I want to go back to the photo that was up there, Dan the Dork. I also want to let you know, I like to fish because it takes me away, physically and mentally, from my day job. All the commonalities, I truly believe in them, but I get to go to beautiful, quiet places by myself, with friends, with family, and do something that is pretty much unrelated to what I do every day. I implore you to find a passion that takes you away. Find something that you will do that allows you to get outside of the daily things that you do. You will catch more fish. So, best of luck. You're now part of a very special UNL family, and we welcome you with open arms. Thank you, and never stop casting.
Thank you very much, Dan. Well done. We will now begin distributing diplomas to our 2021 graduates and congratulatory certificates to members of the class of 2020. Grad Images is here today to photograph every participant as they cross the stage. In the printed program, you will find instructions on how to order your photographs on page 13. The company will also reach out to offer photos from today's ceremony to you. We ask that the audience please remain seated during the ceremony. The doctoral hood is one of the oldest and most meaningful symbols of advanced study, and the graduate faculty at UNL is never prouder than when we place this hood on the shoulders of our students. Before the doctoral candidates receive their degrees today, they will come forward accompanied by their faculty mentor or mentors and be hooded by Dr. Tim Carr, Dean of Graduate Studies. The names of the candidates will be read by Jana McGuire and Mike Zeleny. Doctoral degree candidates from the class of 2021 are listed on page 14, and doctoral degree candidate graduates from the class of 2020 are listed beginning on page 33. I would like to take a moment to thank Dean Tim Carr, who will be retiring from the university later this month. This will be his last commencement ceremony that he presides over for the graduate college here. Dr. Carr has served as Associate Vice Chancellor and Dean of Graduate Education since June of 2018. He previously served in the role on an interim basis starting in April of 2017. Dr. Carr, a professor of nutrition and health sciences, has served as the department chair of nutrition and health sciences and was acting associate dean of academic affairs in our College of Education and Human Sciences. A faculty member here at Nebraska since 1996, he previously held faculty appointments at Wake Forest University School of Medicine and at the University of Minnesota. Dr. Carr earned a Bachelor of Science degree in Biological Sciences from Cal Poly San Luis Obispo and a Master of Science and doctoral degrees, both focused on food and nutrition sciences from the University of Arizona. Dean Carr, will you please come forward? We would like to show our appreciation to you, Tim, with a gesture that will resonate with all of those who are receiving their advanced degrees today. You've been an integral part of the doctoral hooding process at our commencement ceremonies, and we would like to present you with a doctoral hood displaying the UNL scarlet and cream colors and embroidered with our N for a remembrance for your excellent work and support of all of our graduate students. Thank you, Tim. We wish you the very best of luck in your retirement. We appreciate you. We appreciate your work and all of your colleagues in the graduate college. I now turn the microphone over to Dr. Tim Carr.
Thank you, Chancellor. That was unexpected, but greatly appreciated. Today's ceremony is full of tradition, and we honor that tradition by wearing caps and gowns, officially known as academic regalia. Wearing caps and gowns originated in England during the Middle Ages, and that tradition has found its way across the Atlantic to America, where today nearly every academic institution celebrates commencement by wearing caps and gowns. Our university has done so since 1898. The gowns worn by master's degrees recipients are distinguished by the long sleeve extensions, whereas the doctoral gowns have velvet trim and three velvet bands on the sleeves. Please note that one person here today, Chancellor Green, has four bands on his sleeves, which denotes his office. I also want to mention the hoods that are worn over the gowns. The hoods are trimmed in various colors representing the academic disciplines. For example, orange signifies a master's degree in engineering, whereas dark blue indicates the Doctor of Philosophy degree. We will now begin the doctoral hooding. Will graduates with doctoral degrees from the class of 2020 please rise and remain standing? Chancellor Green, I am honored to present to you the candidates from the Graduate College who have fulfilled all requirements for the degree Doctor of Philosophy, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Musical Arts, Doctor of Audiology, and Doctor of Plant Health. They are accompanied to the stage by their faculty mentor.
By authority of the State of Nebraska, vested in the University of Nebraska Board of Regents, and upon recommendation from the graduate faculty, I confer upon each of you the respective degrees, Doctor of Philosophy, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Musical Arts, Doctor of Audiology, and Doctor of Plant Health, according to the particular requirements completed with all of the associated honors, privileges, and responsibilities. Graduates, please be seated.
Will the doctoral candidates from the class of 2021 please rise? Chancellor Green, I am honored to present to you the candidates from the Graduate College who have fulfilled all requirements for the degrees Doctor of Philosophy, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Musical Arts, Doctor of Audiology, and Doctor of Plant Health.
By authority of the State of Nebraska, vested in the University of Nebraska's Board of Regents, and upon the recommendation from the graduate faculty, I confer of each of you in the class of 2021 the respective degrees, Doctor of Philosophy, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Musical Arts, Doctor of Audiology, and Doctor of Plant Health, according to the particular requirements completed with all of the associated honors, privileges, and responsibilities. Graduates, please be seated. Marshals will now escort the doctoral graduates and their faculty presenters to the stage.
Receiving the Doctor of Philosophy, Fitsum Abeba, presented by Professor Guy Trainin.
Danielle Alisi, presented by Professor Amy Nelson Burnett.
Masha L. Al-Twajiri, presented by Professor Holly Hatton Bowers.
Tell me when.
Nancy Anderson, presented by Professor Kurt Geisinger.
Marcus Barbosa, presented by Professor Isabel Velasquez.
Henry Bass, presented by Professor Susan Sheridan.
Rachel Schumacher, presented by Professor Susan Sheridan.
Valir Ben Talib, presented by Professor Margaret Jacobs.
Maria Van Etten Benish, presented by Professor Patrice McMahon.
Angela Bolin, presented by Professor Jessica Koop.
Cameron Bogelfoss, presented by Professor L.J. McElravy.
Nicole Bricko, presented by Professor Edward Daly III.
Brandy Brown, presented by Professor Rajib Saha.
Muhammad Islam, presented by Professor Rahib Saha.
Wheaton Schroeder, presented by Professor Rahib Saha.
Ella Burnham, presented by Professor Aaron Blankenship.
Robert Byram Jr., presented by Professor Michael Scheel.
Thank you. Timothy Cook, presented by Professor Stephen Bueller.
Ethan Davis, presented by Professor Jaesung Park.
Justine Diener O'Leary, presented by Professor Natika Kantamnini.
Boone Evans, presented by Professor Patrick Dussault.
Stephen Fahey, presented by Professor Lim Nguyen.
Sina Musavi, presented by Professor Zhangwan Yun.
Sarah Fisher, presented by Professor William Spalding.
Mansa Fuenta Camacho, presented by Professor Iker Gonzalez Allende.
Christopher Furby, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Nicole Green and Sheila, presented by Professor Amy Goodburn.
Daniel Hayden, presented by Professor Peter Daubin.
Guanhua Hao, presented by Professor Peter Daubin.
Leach, presented by Professor Matthias Schubert.
Trenton Haltom, presented by Professor Kelsey Burke.
Alice Miller McPhee, presented by Professor Kelsey Burke.
Malik Hamami, presented by Professor John Bejean.
Sella Harsey, presented by Professor Jeffrey Smith.
Catherine Hazen, presented by Professor Eve Brank.
Natalie Holt, presented by Professor Deborah Hope.
Elnaz Sadat Hosseini Agdam, presented by Professor Martha Mamo.
Yifeng Hu, presented by Professor David Yule.
Siavash Jafarzada, presented by Professor Florin Babaru.
Shahib Kari Mafard, presented by Professor Yusong Lee.
Cheyenne Caviani, presented by Professor Jeffrey Shield.
Badri Kanal, presented by Professor Tara Mieno.
Annie Kruger, presented by Professor John Ruberson.
Xinwei Liu, presented by Professor Rhonda Fuelberth.
David Mabee, presented by Professor David Jones.
Mitchell McGuire, presented by Professor Wayne Wolt.
Miras Mamiyev, presented by Professor Jiang Hu.
Flavia Mendonca, presented by Professor Jiang Hu.
Ali Mazeltrim, presented by Professor Stephen Morin.
Anastasios Mazis, presented by Professor Tala Awada.
Caitlin Mosher, presented by Professor Susan Swearer.
Filma Glora Mataraj, presented by Professor Satish Kumar Natarajan.
Allison O'Toole, presented by Professor Elizabeth Tice Morse.
Aryamov Panayak, presented by Professor Fernando Osorio.
Taylor Petty, presented by Professor Richard Weiner.
Trace Vartsveen, presented by Professor Richard Weiner.
Marketa Podiebraska, presented by Professor Michael Hayes.
Emily Rao, presented by Professor Melissa Homestead.
Carmen Sylvia Smith, presented by Professor Melissa Homestead.
Jayla Robinson, presented by Professor Christina Falchi.
Vikash Ranjan Sahu, presented by Professor Asit Panayak.
Sunandita Sarkar, presented by Professor Benjamin Terry.
Sean Scanlon, presented by Professor Badras Dermatosian.
Ajay Shankar, presented by Professor Carrick Detweiler.
Nawaraj Shrista, presented by Professor Aaron Mittelstedt.
Kyle Sidaway, presented by Professor Mario Scalora.
Brianna Smith, presented by Professor Kevin Hanrahan.
Luz Sotelo, presented by Professor Joseph Turner.
Cameron Steele, presented by Professor Joy Castro.
Ellie Tavacoli, presented by Professor Lee Tan.
Herb Thompson III, presented by Professor Gina Matkin.
Jesse Tibbs, presented by Professor Dennis McCargo.
Ashley Tony Mulcahy, presented by Professor Virginia Chaidez.
Melanie Trinhale Graneman, presented by Professor Benny Moat.
Alyssa Whitmore, presented by Professor Javier Perez Jimenez.
Mohamedreza Yavari, presented by Professor Prahalada Rao.
Dongdong Zhang, presented by Professor Edgar Cahoon.
Amir Manimiyan Esfahani, presented by Professor Ruigo Yang.
Patrick McNally, presented by Professor William Shomos.
Marlene Grayer Chisulo, presented by Professor Ted Heyman.
Mary Elizabeth Palema, presented by Professor Ted Heyman.
Wendy Kemling Horner, presented by Professor Zhang Gang Zha.
Christine Olson, presented by Professor Amanda Thomas.
Our National Anthem soloist, Trey Meyer, presented by Professor Pamela Starr.
Receiving the Doctor of Musical Arts, Anne Gray, presented by Professor Pamela Starr.
Seung Kyung Peck, presented by Professor Pamela Starr.
Katie Mersch, presented by Professor Anthony Bouchard.
Receiving the Doctor of Plant Pathology, Lindsay Overmeyer, presented by Professor Gary Hine.
And from the class of 2020, receiving the Doctor of Philosophy, Jason Adams, presented by Professor Kent Eskridge.
Zena L. Amili, presented by Professor James Van Etten.
Anna Arciniega, presented by Professor Jane Stratton.
Nirja Sahu, presented by Professor Hamid Sharif.
Subarthi Banerjee, presented by Professor Hamid Sharif.
Pamela Bezos, presented by Professor Michael Hebert.
Julia Rowling Flanagan, presented by Professor Michael Hebert.
Andrew Becklin, presented by Professor Mohammed Ramaha.
Natalia Bjorklund, presented by Professor Judy Wu Smart.
Surbhi Gupta Vakil, presented by Professor Judy Wu Smart.
Caleb Briscoe, presented by Professor Daryl Hatch Tokamiza.
Evangela Oates, presented by Professor Daryl Hatch Tokamiza.
Joshua Camposto de Prado, presented by Professor Wei Chow.
Long Chain, presented by Professor J.K. Sabaya.
Sarah L. Alawi, presented by Professor Bhairav Ramamurthy.
Amy Ensinger, presented by Professor Victoria Malfies.
Sarah Irwin, presented by Professor Rochelle Dalla.
Linda Garcia Merchant, presented by Professor Matt Cohen.
Sarah Gaughan, presented by Professor Kevin Pope.
Zachary Gillen, presented by Professor Joel Kramer.
Teresa Glanz, presented by Professor David Wishart.
Andrew Husa, presented by Professor David Wishart.
Eric Holly, presented by Professor Michael Hayes.
Yaga Guo, presented by Professor Kurt Geisinger.
Sohan Gayawali, presented by Professor Yi Kwan.
Brianna Hitt, presented by Professor Chris Builder.
Majid Jadidi, presented by Professor Alexei Kamensky.
Xuan Yuan Zhang, presented by Professor Zha Xuan Yu.
Michael Jolly, presented by Professor Brent Cheda.
Sean Stewart, presented by Professor Brent Cheda.
Jennifer Cruz, presented by Professor Casey Kelly.
Nam Lee, presented by Professor L.J. McElravy.
Mariah Locklear, presented by Professor Patrick Dussault.
Rodrigo Mendoza, presented by Professor Andrea Bianchini.
Tamara Mittelstadt, presented by Professor Julie Thomas.
Mahdi Muhammad Ighalini, presented by Professor Jeffrey Shield.
Tony Morgan, presented by Professor Jody Koenig-Kellis.
Melissa Olson, presented by Professor Cody Hollist.
Dinesh Pandey, presented by Professor Bijesh Maharjan.
Ahmad Ragay, presented by Professor Daniel Linzell.
Our 2020 Graduate Student Assembly President, Sean Ratcliffe, presented today by Professor Regina Verum.
Matthew Reichenbach, presented by Professor Richard Rebarber.
Brittany Rome, presented by Professor Robert Woody.
Isaac Rucundo, presented by Professor Curtis Weller.
Cody Sheshek, presented by Professor and Vice Chancellor William Nunez.
Celeste Spear, presented by Professor Richard Turaco.
Tyler Spohr, presented by Professor Galen Erickson.
Channing Stellato, presented by Professor Rebecca Lai.
Grace Sullivan, presented by Professor Scott Stoltenberg.
Anna Taylor, presented by Professor Eric Dodds.
Alexandre Tonon Rosa, presented by Professor Rodrigo Worley.
Karina Ewing, presented by Professor Nathan Wakefield.
Amber Vlasnik, presented by Professor Wendy Smith.
Abigail Wachira, presented by Professor Michael Scheel.
Hiruni Vijayasena, presented by Professor Daniel Chiabanu.
Yi Young, presented by Professor Dave Wadeen.
Alyssa Zeidel, presented by Professor Megan Davidson.
Terry Dion, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Kelly Rice, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Leah Richardson, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Devani Johnson, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Tanya Jolly, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Clayton Waddle, presented by Professor Marilyn Grady.
Jennifer Rutt, presented by Professor Nick Pace.
Shanna Gannon, presented by Professor Nick Pace.
Matthew Knight, presented by Professor Nick Pace.
Bowden Christian, presented by Professor Xianggang Sha.
Kaylin O'Shea, presented by Professor Xianggang Sha.
Laura Barrett, presented by Professor Xianggang Sha.
Trina Pettit, presented by Professor Ted Heyman.
Nicole Sorensen, presented by Professor Lisa Carr.
Rebecca Tuttle, presented by Professor Guy Trainin.
Amber O'Shea, presented by Professor Stephanie Wessels.
Receiving the Doctor of Musical Arts, Jared Hiscock, presented by Professor William Shomos.
Susan Cowley, presented by Professor Pamela Starr.
Ruben de Rio Gomez Prada, presented by Professor Carolyn Barber.
Receiving the Doctor of Audiology, Carissa Allen, presented by Professor Emily Wakefield.
Nicole Genrick, presented by Professor Stacy Ray.
Lauren Volsky, presented by Professor Stacy Ray.
Sure.
Will the graduates with master's degrees from the class of 2020 please rise and remain standing? Will the master's degree candidates from the class of 2021 please rise? Chancellor Green, I have the honor to present to you master's degree recipients from the Graduate College who have fulfilled all requirements and are here today to receive their diplomas or their congratulatory certificates. Master's degree candidates from the class of 2021 are listed beginning on page 21. The class of 2020 graduates are listed beginning on page 38.
By authority of the State of Nebraska, vested in the University of Nebraska's Board of Regents, and upon recommendations from the graduate faculty, I confer upon each of you a master's degree according to your particular curriculum and course of study. Congratulations. Please be seated. And before the master's graduates come up, or as they're beginning to come up, I just want the audience to get a chance to hear what we see on the stage. What you just witnessed in the doctoral hooding of our newest doctoral degree holders from the university, if you could see the looks on their faces and the faces of their faculty when those hoods are placed on and get to hear where they are going. We have people all over the United States in faculty positions, in postdoctoral fellow positions, in industry positions, in education positions, serving every sector. Congratulations to each of you. Give our new doctoral candidates a big round of applause.
Andrew Adolf Carl.
Abby K. Hitchler.
William Eugene Schlitowitz.
Erica Lindsay Schimmick.
Brooke Ann Talbot.
Amelia Marie Kingsley Allstadt.
Sawyer Jean Berrigan.
Mary Elizabeth Bennett.
Ashley Joyce Bolton.
Sarah Marie Brettschneider.
Rachel Lynn Doherty.
Amika Zhang Xiao Du.
Caitlin Juliana Dykeman.
Christopher Gale Etheridge.
Taylor Deanne James.
Kiri Kellogg.
Matthew Lee Knapp.
Ethan Koopman.
Bailey Joe Ramos.
Casey Richter.
Sophia Grace Ridge.
Edwin Schooler III.
Sarah Ruth Simon.
Samantha Ray Smith.
Courtney Lee Van Hoosen.
Esmeralda Martina Vasquez.
Brittany Nicole Wombold.
Megan Welling.
Katie Elizabeth Williamson.
Michael Wireko Ajaman.
Zhu Tamayo Zhao.
Katie Maple.
Diego Armando Sanchez.
Lisa Solis.
Teresa Lynn Woods.
Elizabeth Ann Bouchult.
Andrew Joseph McNaughton.
Matthew James Paulo.
Philip Joseph Plonka.
Adam Schlottauer.
Amethyst Holtman Warrington.
Jacob Ryan Ludwig.
Shaney Ray Sorensen.
Amy Sue Thorpe.
Eric Weiler.
Gavin Michael Brown.
Hannah Sierra McKinney.
Emily Ann Olson.
Eli D. Anderson.
Andrew Spencer Ashby.
Luke James Ausdemore.
Mason Baklita.
Brianna Bowens.
Claire Elise Benish.
Eric Michael Bertrand.
Alicia Marie Bevins.
Christopher William Bianchini.
Peyton Lee Boys.
Carmen K. Browett.
Caitlin Nicole Brugenthes.
Walter K. Carson.
Connor Allen Curry.
Timothy Ben Dong.
Jared Duran.
Kathleen A. Engel.
Caitlin Rose Fraser.
Haley Gracie.
Caitlin Marie Glissmeyer.
David Fabian Gomez Quintero.
Audrey Hartwell.
Carly Erin Hilburn.
McKenna Hottavy.
Zhaoyung Huang.
Rebecca Hutchinson.
Alicia Carr.
Aubrey Grace Kemper.
Minho Kim.
Taylor Ann Kindle.
MD Huaman Kobir.
Amanda Lynn Kowalewski.
Kylon Anthony Lang.
Casey Luke.
Tong Lee.
Chi Tao Liu.
Brian Peter Liston Ray.
Sujun Liu.
Emma Lee Loberg.
Andrew Eric Loken. Mallory Lewers.
Kyle R. Martins.
Jasmine Mausbach.
Sean Thomas McDonald.
Iris McFarlane.
Christopher Lewis Muir.
Ipshita Mithra.
Alyssa Hope Molina.
Noel Atieno Muar.
Zoe Louise Myers.
Julia Nuguera Duarte Campos.
Natalia Jo Nolting.
Emily Jolan Pop.
Elizabeth Ann Priester.
Michaela Riddell.
Daniel Anthony Rico.
Olivia Dale Rodriguez.
Luis Gerardo Rodriguez Alviso.
Jing Shao.
Julie Dean Searks.
Madison Sophie Slope.
Brooke Andrea Smith.
Megan Lynn Sneathan.
Joseph August Sonderman.
Mia Tihan.
Quang Viet Phan.
Joshua Edward Timmons.
Ian Michael Sukata.
Kristen Rose Van Katt.
David Velasco Maraquin.
Marie Elizabeth Wagner.
Amber Marie Weir.
Emily Amanda Welch.
Elaine Williams.
Taylor Deanne Williamson.
Macy Elizabeth Wingard.
Miranda Emily Workman.
Kara Ann Zimmerman.
Khadija Sami Zoghib.
And from the class of 2020, Emily Lynn Ball.
Carly Ray Horseman.
Blaine Logan Sharp.
Richard Branton.
Shannon Renee Ankeny.
Tiana Bankhead.
Sydney K. Beatty.
Mackenzie Burke.
Aline Nicole Christensen.
Justin Allen Ellerby.
Amanda Lee Fairley.
Sarah Hesna Ghanem.
Morgan Jean Green.
Whitney L. Jurgens.
Bethany Julene Kraft.
An Fon Lee.
Catherine Elizabeth Duncan Lentz.
Chris Mockian.
Alyssa Marie Mettler.
Andrea Moran.
Amy Sue Peterson.
Jarrett Ramsey.
Lisa Renee Reba.
Ellen Lorraine Grabner Strebar.
Betsy Totten.
Michael Wilson.
Laura Madeline Wiseman.
Alyssa Baber.
Emily Allison Edge Beersdorf.
Zane Goddard.
Earl Thomas Hughes.
Stephanie Lynn Jacobson.
Anne Elizabeth Remington.
Rayanna Hartsgrove.
Austin J. Fricky.
Rachel Irene Hannigan.
Stephen Austin Lesher.
William Charles Green.
Jacqueline Frances Havronic.
Chelsea Cuttis.
Elena Joy Matthews.
Anna Wigtill.
Amanda Lee Fervor.
Abby Joanne Kyle.
Mary Apoka Ampa Asiedu.
Jacob Alexander DeLone.
DMPB Disanayaka.
Talini Kumaral Iknayaka.
Payman Jasem Sade.
Deepak Gimare.
Elizabeth Marie Griffith.
Zachary Dale Horstman.
Mark Keck.
Meredith Concole.
Sumit Mann.
Tiana Meyer.
Laurel Marie McClintock.
Esha Mishra.
Luke Monhollen.
Megan Ringo.
Alexander John Rogge.
Mickey Sandin.
Lawrence Seminario Romero.
Suresh Thanpa.
Tunch Denise Oluda.
Elisa Vasquez.
Colin Patrick Clare.
Catherine Ankerson, Dean of the College of Architecture, will now present the professional degree Master of Architecture.
Will the candidates in the College of Architecture from the class of 2020 and 2021 please rise? Chancellor Green, it is my honor to present these students who have fulfilled all of the requirements for the degree Master of Architecture.
While they're coming up, I'll confer their degrees on them. By the authority of the State of Nebraska vested in the University of Nebraska Board of Regents, and upon recommendations from the faculty of the College of Architecture, I confer upon each of you a master's degree according to your particular curriculum of study in architecture. Congratulations.
Barun Saleh Ismail Barunuri.
Devin McLean.
Please join me in congratulating all of the newest graduate degree holders from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. At this point, we would like to thank those who have helped with today's ceremony. Thank you to the University Commencement and Recognition Committee and to the University Marshall Corps under the direction of Dr. Robert Gorman. Thanks to our Dr. Dan Linzell, our soloist Trey Meyer, who received his doctorate today, and the University of Nebraska faculty brass and percussion. We extend special appreciation to the Office of Graduate Studies staff and the staff of the Office of the University Registrar that we mentioned earlier, who worked to ensure that the students each received their diploma today. Thank you to the staffs of Pinnacle Bank Arena, Husker Vision, and the Office of Special Events for the University for the great care they took in planning and carrying out every aspect of today's ceremony. Now please join me in thanking all the individuals who helped plan and conduct today's ceremony. Congratulations to all of our graduates. The pin that you received today from the Nebraska Alumni Association designates you as a UNL graduate. Wear it proudly. You are now part of an alumni network that reaches worldwide. Please now direct your attention again to the screens for a message from Shelley Zaborowski, Executive Director of the Nebraska Alumni Association.
Congratulations, graduates. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the Nebraska alumni family. Today you join a community of more than 200,000 alumni living all around the world. I encourage you to stay connected and engaged with the university and your fellow alumni as you go forth. The path for your Nebraska experience was paved by those who came before you. It now becomes your privilege and responsibility to pay it forward to the next generation of Huskers through your gifts, not only of treasure, but of time, talent, and experience. We hope you'll join the Alumni Association and discover the many ways you can stay connected. You have much to offer our alma mater, and your continued involvement is critical to Nebraska's success. Once again, congratulations, and welcome to the alumni family.
At this point, I would like to ask all alumni who are in the audience and in our faculty to please stand and greet our newest members to the Nebraska alumni family. Now, graduates, I'm going to ask you to help me make some points here for just a few minutes. I'm going to ask groups of you to please stand and then be seated. First, if you are the first in your family to receive a university degree, would you please stand? Thank you. And while we couldn't be prouder of our first generation graduates, we also are proud of our multi-generation Husker graduates. And we'd also like to recognize those of you who have a family legacy here at the University of Nebraska. If you are the second, third, or perhaps even fifth generation in your family to earn a Nebraska degree, would you please stand? Thank you. If you are a student who came here to Nebraska from outside the United States so we could adopt you here, and you are a graduate today, would you please stand? And if you're a student who came here from the U.S. outside of Nebraska, would you please stand? And you probably figured this one out. If you are a graduate today from the great state of Nebraska, would you please stand? And now, will all of the members of the class of 2020 please rise and remain standing? And now, will those of you in the class of 2021 please join them and rise and remain standing? Graduates, in a moment, I will ask you to move the tassel on your mortarboard from right to left. This symbolic gesture will identify you as a University of Nebraska graduate. You have persevered through a lot of challenges to get here today, especially this past year, and I want to remind you just how rare your accomplishment is. Only 14% of U.S. adults earn an advanced degree. Only about 1 in 7. You are among a very, very few to take on such a high-level academic experience and emerge with success. The emotions that you may feel, ranging from excitement to anticipation and perhaps even to some level of relief, are very well deserved. However, whether earning a graduate or an undergraduate degree, as we'll present tomorrow, I always like to say to you that from those to whom much has been given in the education that you have received and from the people who have worked so hard with you to pursue it, grow and learn in that education. From you, now even more is required. We salute you and we look forward to great things from you in applying and using that education to make the world a better place. We thank you for making us a better university, and we are proud of you and your accomplishments. We hope that the pride that we have in you is reciprocal, and that wherever you go, you are eager to proclaim that your credentials are from the University of Nebraska. Please now move your tassel from right to left, as we salute you as the graduates of the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. Congratulations to all of you. Will the platform party and the faculty please rise? Family and friends, please remain seated until the recessional has been completed. The August graduate commencement exercises are now concluded. University marshals, please begin the recessional.